Well, good morning, guys. The rear shock dilemma on Frankenbuggy is in its second day. And I spoke with my friend that gave me these lighter springs. And he said he watched the video I posted yesterday and that he believes it's more of an issue of the shock valving than the weight of the springs, which now further observation of this vehicle, I'm starting to believe that's correct, because the resting height of it is actually fairly low. Let me show you that the rear end is actually sagging a few inches. When I jack this thing up, there's like 2.5 inches of sag. So, and another issue similar to the front shocks, this collar here is all the way down. So when this collar here bottoms out, it compresses this spring here, runs this up into that, then all the load is on the heavier spring. So I don't think that that was an issue, because I wasn't even getting that much travel when I was hitting the speed bumps. But you can see that it's not using the entire upper spring here, because this will run into that and then this one takes over. So it just so happens I looked for an Allen wrench and I didn't have one that size. It's like in between 2 and 2.5 millimeters. So I don't know if it's American, which I didn't have, or what. But we'll get that loosened up so we can adjust those collars. And my friend said, yeah, bring them on down and we'll go ahead and revalve these and see if we can't get these shocks working for you. So I'm going to jack this thing up. And when I do, you can notice just how much sag we do have on this. And then I'll pull these shocks off and get them down to the shop. So let's get this done. And pay attention to how much it actually is sagging when I jack it up here. Now those wheels are airborne, and that was quite a bit of drop there. So whatever those shocks dropped, that's the sag that we got. So let's get some jack stands under this. I'm gonna lower it a little bit. I do want those tires on the ground. All right, guys, we got the shocks off. The car is supported by jack stands. We'll get on down to the shop and get these shocks revalved. Hopefully that'll work. All right, we'll be back in a bit. Well, hey guys, we made it to the shop and we got one of the shocks apart here. And what he was explaining to me is that the shim stacks determine how much fluid will actually flow past the piston here. And the different thicknesses equal the rigidity of them. And of course, the thicker they are, the less they'll be able to flex and allow fluid to pass by. So we're gonna measure some shims and make all the adjustments so things aren't so darn stiff in the shock. So, and then we'll go ahead and we'll use the lighter springs because those will work out just fine. And yeah, we're gonna make some shocks that work here. This is pretty exciting. So I'll be back in a bit and we'll see you later. So what has been explained to me is that here is a shock rod, the valving that just came out of one of the shocks. And you see all these washers that's on the top there. Well, those hold those tight against all the shims there. And what he is going to do when he rebuilds this one, sticks the new lighter shims in there, is actually put one of these washers down below. So you're actually, the valving is not near as tight. It will allow a lot more hydraulic flow there. But you can see right now, I mean, it is dependent solely on those shims for any kind of movement and valving. And it was super tight. So we'll take a look at this after he gets all the shims and reworks the spacers there, and we'll see what it looks like then. So I'll be back. All right, guys, well, I made it back home well, I'm real excited to get these shocks back on Frank and Buggy and take it for a rip and see how it works. The last clip that I did was in the shop, and it was how the washers would not allow fluid to flow. And well, my friend there, he just I didn't get that second clip in there because he just wanted to get the work done, and you know, he did it for me for free as a favor, and I really appreciate that. And so I didn't want to keep hey let me do a clip. So anyways, the clip showed three washers up underneath the shims, which basically didn't allow any flex at all to those shims, which would allow very, very little fluid to pass by. And what that does is make your shocks extremely stiff. So when he put it back together, instead of three stacked up, he had just one stacked up. Put one on the bottom, two on the top, instead of all three on the bottom, which basically locks the valving pretty much closed. And so that's how we made it, just one on the bottom, two on the top, instead of three on the top there. And we're gonna give it a shot, see how it works. If we got to go back in, make a correction, we can, but at least we know where we stand now. We got into the valving, we got into the springs, and it's just all that has to be done to tune a suspension to work for these off-road vehicles. We ended up using the 400 pound springs on the bottom here and 200 on top. He said this should be a good combination. I got the threes there if we do have to change it. And ultimately what's going to happen with Frank and Buggy is that we're going to be putting a Subaru motor in it, and which involves a radiator. It's a bigger, heavier motor than a Volkswagen. So what will probably happen is these 200s will come off of here and the 300s will go in their place. So right now the VW is fairly light, so the 200 for the preload springs should work out, but I'm gonna put these shocks on, and then we'll go for a rip and hit the speed bumps. Hopefully I don't piss off the neighbors too bad, and you know, let's get this done. We'll see how it works. So I'll be back in a little bit, and we'll take a little drive. All right, guys, well, you got the shocks mounted on here. Let's take it for a rip around the neighborhood and see how the speed bumps look. We'll be right back. Well, guys, as you can see, springs are working a lot better, valving, everything. That thing just flew over them speed bumps, no problem at all. So yeah, I know it's been a few days since we had the work done on the springs, but as I showed in the clip before that, old Frankenbuggy wasn't running too good. So I actually went through, did a little carburetor work, and well, the valve adjustment was wrong. I looked on the internet, and it told me to set the valves, I think, at 4,000ths for the exhaust and intake. And the correct setting was 8,000ths on the intake and 12 on the exhaust. So it started popping through the tailpipe and all that. It's like, what the heck's going on here? So after a little bit of tuning, Frankenbuggy's is ripper again. So we'll see you on the next one. Take care now.